This week on the Box Pregame Show, we tell you why one game is making professional lacrosse history.
Then we get you ready for the big games in week two action.
And hear from two-time MVP Sean Evans as the New England Black Wolves get ready to start 2017.
Don't go anywhere, all that and more coming up on this episode of the Box Pregame Show. And welcome to this episode of The Box. Mia Gordon and Tyson Geick here from NLL Productions, getting you ready for week two action. Four big games taking place this weekend.
We're pumped up for all the action this weekend. Lots more than face-off weekend. There's some significant storylines that we're going to be touching on in this episode of The Box, and it's all to come.
But let's get you ready for all the games that are happening this weekend. First off, starting with the first game in Calgary as the Stealth visit the Roughnecks. The Calgary Roughnecks open up their homestand this weekend against the Vancouver Stealth. One team coming off a division final appearance last year, the other hoping to turn around after a last place finish in the West. The Roughnecks are a team that hasn't seen much change in the offseason, just three different players in the lineup in 2017, including an unchanged right side with powerhouse Curtis Dixon, who had a 61-goal season in 2016. He is joined by Wes Berg and Tyler Digby, who pose an offensive threat to any opponent they face this season. As for the South, they are still in search of their first playoff appearance in Vancouver. They will look to Reese Dutch and Logan Schuss, who will serve as an assistant captain for the first time this season, to step up. Vancouver visits Calgary Friday, January 6, 9 p.m.
Let's get right into the two-minute drill. Tyson, we have one team that made it to the division finals. Then we have one team that finished last in the division. What can we expect from this matchup?
For the Calgary Roughnecks, I expect that they're going to come out in their home opener and give their fans something to cheer about. They'll be missing a couple of players like Greg Harnett and goaltender Frank Scigliano due to suspensions in the Christmas showdown, which means Christian DelBianco will be making his much anticipated first NLL start in goal. If you're Vancouver, you want to get to the young goaltender early and get on the board fast. This presents a golden opportunity for the Stealth.
Tyson, Calgary is a very familiar team. Not a lot of changes in the offseason. In fact, their entire right side is still the exact same. They have that powerhouse of Curtis Dixon, but it seemed that the left side was the weaker side. Has the team done anything in the offseason to improve on this?
The Roughnecks went out and acquired Riley Lowen in the offseason from the Saskatchewan Rush. He is a lefty. We're going to see what that does for the left-hand side. Calgary is a team that didn't have to make that many changes in the offseason, though. They had nine games last year that were decided by just one goal that led the NLL in that category. Their offense looked good last year. They're deep defensively, and having not many changes made, I expect them to play a tighter defensive game this season as well.
Tyson, as for Vancouver, this is a team that's coming into the season with a few key injuries. They really want to get a good start this year, but how do they do that?
Well, they need their strong offensive guys to be strong to start the season. Reese Dutch had a really strong year last year, and then there's players like Corey Small, like Joel McCready and Logan Schuss that also need to be really strong offensively. On the defensive side, that's where my question marks are kind of brought up. Matt Beers is on the back end. He's a very strong defender, and he's going to need to be a voice on the back end. But then it kind of trails off. They were very weak defensively last year, and it's a spot in their game that they need to tighten up. And against the Calgary Roughnecks, they simply can't afford to have those defensive blunders early on to start the season, and they're going to need to come out fast and tighten everything up really quickly in this game.
Well, the weekend continues with a very historic game as the Georgia Swarm welcome the Saskatchewan Rush. We'll get into just why this is historic in this game preview.
It is a historic game in Georgia as they welcome the Saskatchewan Rush this weekend. For the first time in professional lacrosse, four brothers will compete in one game. Miles, Lyle, and Jerome Thompson will be fighting for the Swarm, while Jeremy Thompson will be wearing the Rush jersey. Besides this being a historic game, it is also a game that will see two contenders go head-to-head. The Rush are coming off their second Champions Cup win and are looking to start on a positive note in 2017 as they try and make it a three-peat. As for Georgia, their star rookies entering their sophomore year with more experience under their belt are looking to make an even bigger impact in 2017. Three of their top six scorers last year were in their first year. Combine that young talent with vet leaders like Shane Jackson and Johnny Palas, this is a team in the hunt for the Cup. Four Brothers, one game, Georgia versus Saskatchewan, January 7th, 7.05 p.m.
Four Brothers, one game, a very historic moment. We'll get to that a little bit later on in the show. But to start off this two-minute drill, Tyson, I know you had the chance to talk with the Brothers. Just how important is this moment to them?
This is going to be a very special night for these four brothers. They're going to have a lot of friends and family on hand for this game, and they're going to have a lot of fun out there. But I really don't expect that to distract them from focusing on what's important in this game, and that is coming out with a win to start the season for the respective teams.
Well, speaking of what is important, besides just a historic game, these are two potential Champions Cup contenders. So can you talk about this matchup?
Well, Saskatchewan Rush are a team that everyone's talking about around the league, and they're looking good. They're strong offensively and strong defensively, and not many changes were made to their roster. But for their goaltending situation, Aaron Bold is going to be suspended to start the season in this first game due to that Christmas showdown. So Tyler Carlson will be in between the pipes. He doesn't have a lot of experience recently in the NLL. I think he appeared in just four games last season. So if Georgia wants to get to the Saskatchewan Rush, they need to do it by penetrating the goaltender early on in this one and putting a lot of shots on net.
As for Georgia, the rookies had such a strong campaign last year, including the Rookie of the Year, Randy Stotts, then Lyle Thompson having a big season in Georgia. So now that they're heading into the sophomore year, can we expect even more out of this young team?
I think you can. I don't expect any of these young players to have any sort of a sophomore slump. These are all great athletes. They worked hard in the offseason, and I think they're going to come back to the 2017 season with a brand new focus, and they're going to be really confident. And I'm really looking to the youth on Georgia to step up and carry this team into 2017.
The weekend then continues in Rochester. They continue their homestand there against a tough opponent in the New England Black Wolves. So let's take a look at that game preview.
The Rochester Nighthawks continue their homestand against another East Division rival, the New England Black Wolves. The Nighthawks coming off a week one home loss to the Toronto Rock and are looking to bounce back, but it won't be easy against a Black Wolves team stacked with veteran talent. The two met in the preseason with Rochester edging the Black Wolves 9-8, but now it's a different story. The Nighthawks have a bevy of new faces with only three of their seven forwards having extensive NLL experience as they face off against a roster of vets like two-time MVP Sean Evans. Will it be the rookie talent or the veteran experience that wins out at the end of the day? We find out as the Black Wolves take on the Nighthawks Saturday, January 7th, 7:30 p.m.
You have one team that is stacked with veteran leadership, another one that is stacked with rookie talent. What can we expect from this matchup?
Well, Mia, I think that the Rochester Nighthawks are going to have their work cut out for them in the second game of their season. You've got a league MVP finalist in Sean Evans and goaltender of the year in Evan Kirk, not to mention a brand new faceoff specialist in Jay Thornburg, who came over from the Buffalo Bandits. I don't know how much Rochester will have been able to tighten things up in just a week, but we might have another blowout here on our hands.
You speak of in just a week, losing last week to Toronto at home. So what can they do?
Well, they need to focus on the little things, keep things really simple for the young guys on the team. And that's going to be all about winning loose ball battles, focusing on having your man defensively and not letting up on the offensive talent on the New England Black Wolves. Set picks hard and really be cross-checking hard when you are playing defense. And I think that's going to be the name of the game. Just keeping it simple and winning the little battles. You hear that, it's such a cliche in sports, winning the little battles. But if you go there, you take things one step at a time, I think that's going to be where you start for the Rochester Nighthawks.
As for the New England Black Wolves, this is a team that lost in the division finals last season. This is a team that we know wants to go all the way. So what do they have to do to start 2017 off on the right foot?
Hey, follow the advice that I gave to the Rochester Nighthawks just a few seconds ago. Take things one game at a time. This is a very competitive league. You can't take a night off. It's a relatively short season. There's only 18 games. So every game really matters. And just one loss could really come back to hurt you. So don't be looking ahead to the next week. Focus on the Rochester Nighthawks. Take them down in the first game of your season, and the rest will follow.
Speaking of Sean Evans, who we mentioned a little bit earlier, we had the chance to sit down with him ahead of the season.
I guess the favorite lacrosse story was, you know, probably from last year. Playing Georgia Swarm, first round of playoffs, you know, especially if New England coming from a tough year. The year before, making playoffs. Or it's tie game. I think it was at 10 seconds left. Actually, it's overtime. So first goal wins, and we got the ball, got the rebound from Kyle Buchanan, got the ball out, passed it to Kevin Crowley. Kevin Crowley stepped in for a shot, threw the back end to me, and I buried the game winner to go to the semifinals. So, you know, it was a good start for this franchise, and see the fans go nuts. I think everyone who was in that building was pretty excited and got the chills going on there. I think so. It was good. That was my favorite moment. That's my holiday special for this year. For it's there, but it's a new season. You have to get over it quickly. I think that semifinals kind of went either way. I think if we had maybe a stop there, or we scored in opportunities that we had, that series could have went our way. Well, I think you can never be satisfied. I think you always want to work to strive to be better and to do better. And if you feel like you just want to be the same, you're not going to go anywhere. You know, I like winning. I like winning championships, and I thrive off that. So, I think just trying to lead that way, and just trying to learn different aspects of the game. There's different aspects. Setting picks and doing different things on the floor to make your team successful. It's something that really look forward to when you finish last season. You want to get going again. I know you say sometimes you want to break, but you give it 4 or 5 days a week, and you want to get going again. So. To be ready to get going, we're 2-3 weeks away from the opening day, and that excitement's starting to build, and it's I'm ready for it. We're going to be a lot better, and we had a competitive camp, and I think everyone's excited to get back going and start hanging out with the guys again and to have some fun and build that identity, Black Wolves identity that we built last year. Hearing that story of the NL logo and how it looked, it was great. Being in this league, like I said, 13 years, seeing a lot. Over the years, it's been a steady incline, but I think we're ready to take that next level. And I think Nick's doing a great job to, to go that direction and to, get the growth off the ground and to build the NHL where it should be. To basically 30 teams like the NBA, NHL teams, and to take off and build this league into, a big industry.
Week two wraps up in the West as Vancouver continues their weekend up against Colorado. So let's take a look at that game preview. Week two wraps up in Colorado as the Mammoth welcome the Vancouver Stealth for their season home opener. The Mammoth are looking to keep the momentum going after a win on the road against the Bandits in week one. A key offseason addition of Zach Greer shined with a hat trick, and the team will look to him to continue up front. While the defense was on fire, goaltender of the year finalist Dylan Ward had 47 saves on 55 shots on goal. Vancouver will be coming off another tough division game in Calgary. Will they be able to spoil the Mammoth's home opener hopes? Tune in January 7th at 9 p.m. to find out. Tyson, in this two-minute drill, I want to start off with Colorado. We spoke in our post-game show just how strong they looked as they opened up the season in Buffalo. Now they're coming home. What do they need to do to keep this momentum going on home turf?
I spoke with a lot of the players on the Colorado Mammoth last weekend, and what they told me about Banditland was that it was a lot like the Loud House down in Colorado. Now, the last thing that the Colorado Mammoth are going to want to do in this game is come out flat like the Buffalo Bandits did in their home opener, and I think that they're going to learn a lot from the Bandits. If they can perform like they did last week, and that means getting in the lanes of shots, blocking shots, winning loose ball battles, and playing strong defensively, I think they're going to do just fine against the Vancouver Stealth.
As for the Vancouver Stealth, They are playing against Calgary in Calgary just a few days earlier. As someone who has played this game, how difficult is it to play back-to-back games? And not just back-to-back games, but back-to-back games on the road.
Well, this is extremely difficult, and it brings me back to playing for the New Westminster Salmon Bellies in the Minto Cup back in 2010. We were taking on the Coquitlam Atanacs and the Orangeville Northmen, and to put this into perspective for you, I would say about 70% of the players between the two teams are now playing in the NLL. Extremely tough matchups, and you have to almost forget about the one game that you played and come out strong with another game not long after. Your body takes a beating, you're exhausted, and what happens in between those two games is you often bring a lot of mental mistakes into the next game because you're simply tired. You're making mistakes that could possibly cost your team. So to bring this back to Vancouver, I think what they're gonna need to do is to limit those mental mistakes. They're gonna need to hydrate in between their two games and really look after their bodies and not make those mental mistakes against the Colorado Mammoth, because that is a team that can very well capitalize against you when you are making poor errors.
I know we've spoken a lot about just how strong Colorado's defense was looking. The Bandits couldn't find a way past it. Can Vancouver, are there any weaknesses that you saw?
Not very many weaknesses that I could see in Colorado. It's going to be very difficult for the Vancouver Stealth to take down the Mammoth in this one. And I think Colorado's really going to feed off that home crowd in this game. Vancouver is going to have a real tough challenge in this game here.
That wraps up our game previews and two-minute drills for week two. So let's get to outside the box. We've spoken a lot about the historic game that is happening this weekend. Tyson, you actually had a chance to sit down with the four brothers for this edition.
I really enjoyed talking with the Thompson brothers in this one, and I found out a little bit about the two-on-two battles that they had in backyard lacrosse growing up. And it's all coming up in this edition of Outside the Box. Saturday night will be a big night for the game of lacrosse. Not only will the defending Champions Cup winning Saskatchewan Rush take on the Georgia Swarm to start their season, it will also be a night in which professional lacrosse history is made. Since they were kids, brothers Jeremy, Miles, Jerome, and Lyle all played the sport of lacrosse with one another. Playing the game they loved, they made a ton of memories. But now they're in the big leagues and are ready to make history. Saturday night will mark the first time that professional lacrosse will have seen four brothers competing in the same game. Jerome, Miles, and Lyle of the Georgia Swarm will all take on their oldest brother, Jeremy, of the Saskatchewan Rush, in front of friends and family in Georgia.
So for me, it's very exciting, you know, coming in a new season and starting out against my brothers.
Pretty cool just to see four brothers, you know, at the highest level of their sport playing against each other or with each other. And, you know, it's another great moment in our, you know, our lacrosse history that, you know, I'm going to enjoy.
To all be on the same floor at the same time, playing against each other and with one another, It's a crazy feeling, and I know it's, you know, my parents are really happy. They're, a lot of my family is going down for the game, so, you know, it's bringing a lot of joy to my family.
To have four brothers playing in one lacrosse game together, it's unreal to be able to be there and experience that.
The Thompson brothers always had a stick in their hands growing up and recall going two-on-two in their backyard.
It's always me and Jeremy together as teammates, and Miles and Jerome together, and Miles and Jeremy have this thing where they just battle it out all the time. It turns into like a little bit of a fight.
Miles and Jerome were quick to offer their older brother and adversary, Jeremy, a piece of advice for Saturday night.
Yeah, I mean, I give him this advice every year. Don't let me backdoor you. And I always play against Jeremy. That's how I get most of my goals, is backdoor him. When he's looking away, I backdoor him. And my rookie season, what did I do to get my first goal? Backdoored my own brother.
He's going to be playing defense. He plays on my side of the floor, so advice I'd give to him, keep his head up.
Jeremy Thompson is a two-time Champions Cup winner with the Rush organization. He set an example for his brothers, who hope to follow in his footsteps with an NLL championship.
You know, Jeremy's the one I always looked up to, I always tried to be like.
The hard work that he's put in, and you know, I think I know what it takes. And that just makes me, you know, want it even more, because I don't know what that feeling's like. So, you know, that's what everyone's there for. They want that feeling. They want that championship game. They want to be able to play in it. And, you know, I'm hungry for that.
just knowing that he's won that Champions Cup before, I mean, it just makes it that much more push that you want to strive for that.
As for Jeremy, he's feeling confident that the Rush can three-peat in 2017.
We're back. We're ready here with a new season with the Rush, and you know, we have a darn good team. You know, right from our goaltending to defense transition up all the way to our offense, and you know, we're firing on all cylinders. Fired up for a new season here.
Don't miss the Georgia Swarm taking on the Saskatchewan Rush. Subscribe to NLL TV and watch on as the Thompson brothers make professional lacrosse history. Four brothers, one game. Saturday night. For NLL Productions, I'm Tyson Geick.
That wraps up this episode of The Box. Four big games taking place this weekend. We hope to see you out at the games. But if you can't make it, don't worry. All you have to do is subscribe to NLLTV.com to make sure you don't miss any of the action.
Thanks for tuning into this episode of The Box. For Mia Gordon, I'm Tyson Geick. Take care, folks.